Hello everyone! For those of you who know me already, welcome back to my channel. And for those of you who don't know me already, my name is Dragos Pepina and I'm a pet portrait artist based in Belgium. In today's video I'm going to finally finish this butterfly piece, and this is going to be the part 4 of my real-time monarch butterfly tutorial. And I'm going to finish the flower in this video. If you want to follow and draw along with me, I would really recommend for you guys to watch the first 3 parts where I drew the rest of the butterfly. And after to come here on this video and follow me on drawing the flower. It is very important for you guys to do the first 3 parts because otherwise it wouldn't make sense. I think it would be a great idea to start first with the body and the wings and after to finish with the flower. But you can do what you want. If you want to start first with the flower and after with the butterfly, you are free to watch first this video with the flower and then continue with the ones with the body and the butterfly. But I would really recommend for you guys to draw first the butterfly and as well the flower in the end, in order for you to follow the same steps as me. I'm going to link the previous videos somewhere on the screen and as well in the description below for you guys to find it easier. I really hope you're going to enjoy it and have fun together with me. Now, without further ado, let's get into the video. Now I'm going to show you what colors I'm going to use for the flower. And I have here some color swatches. And I'm going to use light cadmium yellow, this one. And as well dark chrome yellow, this one. Cadmium orange, which is this one, and walnut brown, which is this one. I'm going first to start out by remaking the sketch of the flower because it is, as you can see, it is very blurry and it's not very visible anymore. And then I'm going to start with the base layers and start adding shadows and layers and highlights and everything. So I'm going to first start recreating the sketch. I don't want to follow the reference photo 100%. I'm just going to fast drawing what I'm seeing and don't stress about that if you didn't follow the reference photo. If you didn't follow the reference photo 100%, just give yourself time for creativity and as well just enjoy it. Don't have to follow the exact size of the flower from the reference photo. Like I'm doing now, I'm just kind of free sketching, but by following the reference photo. Of course, you need to make sure that in the end it's going to look like a flower, so you need to pay a bit of attention on the shape of the flower. But what I meant by not following it 100% is to make it look like a flower, but as well leave space for your creativity. And as I said in my previous videos, I'm really sorry if you are going to hear again like weird noises from outside, but my neighbors are working again on their roof and it's possible they are going to hear some very annoying sounds, and I'm really sorry for that. If they are going to be very loud, I'm going to add some background music. Maybe this way I'm going to cover some of those sounds, but I hope it won't be the case because I want for you guys to hear me very clear. I don't want any background music and to risk for you guys to not understand what I'm saying. So let's hope they're going to be quiet today, not like the previous times when they were very, very loud. Just going to hope it's going to be good in the end and they're going to be very quiet. So as I said, before I'm just free sketching the petals of the flower and making sure it's going to look like a flower. I'm not very good at flowers. To be honest, I don't think I have ever drew a flower, but this is not a very complicated flower. It's more like a bit in the blur, so it's not in the main focus in the photo, in the reference photo, but I'm going to try to take that blur away and make it look like it's in the focus, the same with the butterfly. So in the same focus with the butterfly, just to make it more, to make it pop out more. I don't want for the flower to get lost into the other details. I want the flower to be a part of the drawing as well. So I'm just easily following the reference photo. I'm not stressing, as I said, I don't want to put too much pressure on myself to recreate the exact details of the flowers. I'm going to be very pleased if in the end it is going to look like a flower. And I think it is going to look like a flower, because you can't do much wrong with the flower. It's very easy to get the basic shape of the flower. I just noticed that the first video of this butterfly, so the first part of this butterfly, was very successful. It has, I think right now, 220 views on YouTube, and a pretty good watch time and as well retention. But I was a bit disappointed to see that the second and third part, they didn't do very good and people weren't very interested. And I can't say it hurt, but it felt very disappointing, because I put so much work and I took time from my commissions to make this drawing and to film it for you guys and to explain all the steps, and people weren't very interested. So I think people just want to see like tutorials for how to draw a dog nose or cat eye or something like this. I don't think people want to draw along with me, so I think I'm just going to focus on those tutorials more instead of making videos like this where you cannot draw along with me, because I don't want to waste more time. I want to use my time for what is going to be searchable and as well for what people want to see, instead of losing time for something that doesn't have a lot of interest for people. So we are going to see on my channel a lot of tutorials of how to draw a dog eye, a dog mouth, cat eye, but they're going to be as well in real time. So they're going to be videos like this, but I'm going to do it in real time, not like other YouTubers. They make like a 10 minutes time lapse and they just voice over it. I'm going to do it in real time, so for you guys to be able to draw along with me and to follow every step I make. And as well, I find that by drawing in real time, I can explain my ideas better, and I'm making sure I don't forget what I want to say, because if I'm drawing first and I'm making a voice over it, I'm going to lose a lot of ideas that I had while drawing it. So if I'm going to draw it and film it in the same time, I'm going to be able to say everything I want to say, instead of always thinking after that I don't remember what I want to say. So I'm going to do that, and hopefully they're going to be more successful than these ones. But I don't complain. I really enjoyed it, and it was a lot of fun to do this butterfly. So now I'm going to start on the layers. I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow to create a base layer. I'm going to start here. I hope you can see the color, it's very bright. I'm not going to apply a very hard pressure because this color is very pigmented, so just by applying a very light pressure you can already see how vibrant it is, so it doesn't take a lot of pressure in a lot of layers to create this shape, this layer, sorry. I'm going to start with these three first and I'm going to work on them and to do the same thing on the other ones. I'm really looking forward to see the results you guys made if you drew along with me and to see how your butterfly turned out. It's very exciting to see other people's drawings made after mine and I'm really looking forward to it. So I'm applying a very light pressure just to create a very fast base layer. And I'm going to pick up my dark chrome yellow, the same color I used for the butterfly, so for these lighter parts. And I'm going to create a bit of a shadow. Here I can see one. So I'm just going to mark it a bit here, just to see, to have an idea where I'm going to stop with the shading. And I'm going to add a very light layer. Just to keep that highlight there, so I'm going to add a very light layer, and as well here around it I'm going to make it a bit darker. And here I need to leave it untouched because I noticed in the reference photo there's no shadow there. And I'm going to create a shadow here. I hope you can see very good. I hope my hand is not in the way. But it's very difficult to add a harder pressure if I'm holding my pencil very far from the tip. I'm going to try to keep my hand away from the image as often as possible. And as you can hear, my neighbors already started with their annoying noises. So I think I need to put some relaxing music over my voice in the end because I don't want for you guys to listen to those sounds. So I'm applying a very light pressure and just building that shade. I really love working with yellow colors because they are very bright, so yellows and oranges, they have such a bright pigment and they really bring the drawing to life. And they are as well very colorful photos, very colorful colors, and it's always a pleasure to work with them. I don't get to work with them in my commissions a lot because I don't think a lot of dogs have yellow, very bright yellow fur or very orange fur. I mostly use a lot of browns, black and white, terracotta as well, but I only use these colors, so the yellows and oranges. When the dog has an accessory, for example a collar or something else, then I get to use those colors, but most of the times I don't, so that's why I'm going to enjoy this so much. I still have a lot of colors in my Faber-Castell Polychromas kit, which I've never used before, so they are untouched. And I hope someday I'm going to get to use them. So I'm just working the shadow in these three petals. And I see a very dark shadow here in the middle. I'm just going to apply a very hard pressure just to create a shadow here and to make the other petals pop out more. I'm Okay, so now I'm going to add a bit of this color here as well. Just a very light layer to make it even more vibrant. I'm being careful not to make it too dark because I don't want to cover the base layer I just created. I just want to kind of glaze it a bit. So I'm just applying light pressure, and now I'm going to use my cadmium orange to make the things even darker. So I'm going to create a very fast shadow here, just following the reference photo. And all this area here, it's very dark orange, so I'm going to apply a harder pressure to create that shadow I see in the reference photo. And now I'm going to use my walnut brown color to make it even darker. Just trying to create a shadow here. I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow to make it even more vibrant because I want to make sure it doesn't look muddy, so I'm going to glaze it a bit with the light cadmium yellow just to take away a bit of that muddy color because I don't want it to look very brown. I'm going to burnish that color up a bit with my light cadmium yellow color by applying a very hard pressure. And now I'm going to use my cadmium yellow again just to make the things darker a bit. Something like this. And I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow color just to make this part here a bit more vibrant. As I said in my previous videos, it is very important to work in layers and to give yourself as much time as you need. Because if you are going to hurry it, it won't turn up good and you won't enjoy it in the end. And it's not the purpose of drawing. I know I already said that in the previous video, but I just want to remind you guys why you shouldn't hurry. I was really tended to hurry in the previous video because I noticed it was already taking too long to finish the other part of the wings. And I was trying to hurry, and at one moment I realized that I didn't enjoy it anymore because I was stressing too much, because it was taking too long, and I noticed I wasn't enjoying it anymore. So I told myself to slow down and enjoy it, and it doesn't matter if it's going to take too long. It's important that I'm going to enjoy it in the end. And as well that I gave myself as much time as I needed and it turned out good in the end, so that's why I keep repeating, don't hurry, you have enough time, nobody's hurrying you to finish this butterfly, or nobody's hurrying me to finish this butterfly, even if it takes too long. I still put the third part, took me 2.5 hours to finish. And I put on YouTube the video which took 2.5 hours. And in the beginning I was stressing that it takes so long that people are not going to enjoy it and they are going to skip it. And it kind of did that because, as I told you, the third video wasn't very successful. And but that's okay. I just wanted to help you guys, and who knows, maybe in the future other people interested in drawing together with me are going to find it and make this butterfly as well. So now I'm glazing a bit the colors with my dark chrome yellow by applying a very very light pressure. And now I'm going to use my cadmium orange color just to darken things, everything, to darken up things like this part here. Applying a harder pressure, and I want to make this edge a bit darker just to frame this petal here. A bit of darkness here. I'm really thinking to start making live streams on YouTube, but I don't think I can now because I don't have the right materials. I noticed I need to buy some extra things in order to go live on YouTube, but this is for sure one of my purposes in the future. I really want to stream live and to talk to people live. That will be very interesting and terrifying at the same time because I'm going to be afraid by making mistakes in English or not knowing what to say to people if they ask something. But I'm really willing to try it and to see how it's going on. And I hope my neighbors are going to be done with the working by then, so I can have a nice live chat session with you guys instead of having that annoying sound in the background. So now I'm using my cadmium orange to add some shadows. Now I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow to burnish these petals a bit and to make them brighter. So here and here as well, and one more here. And in the end here, by applying a very hard pressure. And now I'm going to use my walnut brown just to darken this area in the middle a bit. Like this, and my cadmium orange color to work a bit more on this highlight here, on this shadow, sorry. Like this. And some smaller ones here in the bottom. It's a very nice and sunny day today in Belgium, so I'm really glad for that That means the lighting of this video is going to be very good. And I won't have to keep changing the lighting of the camera, because when it's cloudy and the sun gets out sometimes from the clouds, I always need to keep an eye on my camera to see how the lighting is, because it keeps changing when it's a cloudy day. But if it's the whole day sunny like now, I hope it's going to be the whole day sunny. The sun is always up, and that means it's going to be the same lighting all the time, which is going to make me very happy when I'm going to edit this video and not having to change the lighting and correct it or something. So it's a win-win situation for me. The only bad thing is that of course the neighbors are working and you can hear those sounds in the background. And now I'm going to use my walnut brown color just to darken this up a bit. Like this, and a bit here, just a very light layer, just to create a bit of more contrast and dimension, to give more contrast and dimension to that pattern. And as I said in the beginning of this video, I don't think I have ever drew a flower before. So it's the first time for me as well, and I just keep learning. And I'm going to use now my walnut brown again to create just a bit more shadow here and a bit darker. And here as well. Think something like this, it looks good. And a bit of dark chrome yellow color here to darken this up a bit and to make it look more orangey instead of yellowish. So I'm applying a hard pressure. And I want to make sure I don't touch this area, because I'm going to drag the walnut brown color into the light one here, and it's going to look muddy, and I don't want that, so I'm being very careful. And as you can see, I hope you can see here, I leave a very light space, a very light highlight, to come back in the end to cover it, because I'm going to work it on it now. The brown color is going to spread everywhere here, so by leaving this part here untouched, I can go back in the end and work on that area and make sure if it's going to smudge, I'm going to muddy this, I'm going to make only this little small portion here to look muddy instead of making the whole area look muddy. So I'm going to do it now. So my camera stopped, I'm sorry guys for that. My camera can only film for half an hour, and after it's going to stop. And it just stopped, but hopefully I just lost 1 minute from talking. So I was saying about this part here, that I'm going to create a highlight using my slides tool, and I love to use this tool for highlights. It's so easy to use, and the effect is very nice. And now I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow color just to burnish this brown here and to make it look more vibrant, because I think it looks a bit too muddy. So I'm applying a very, very hard pressure. And here as well, just to make it like a bit more vibrant. And now I'm going to erase this outline here, because I want to make a very light color and I don't want outline to be seen. So I'm going to recreate the outline by using my light cadmium yellow and by applying a very hard pressure. I'm going to look that to make that area look very vibrant. So this is just a base layer. And now I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow to create a second layer and to make this color darker and as well more vibrant. Just by applying a light pressure. I don't want to make it too dark. So something like this. I think I really need to put some background music, because I noticed also my neighbors from upstairs, they started to talk loud. Also the neighbors who are working on their roof, they started being very loud with their machines. So I think I really need to put a sound in the end over my voice, because this is not going to work. So I created a very light layer here, and I noticed I just made my drawing a bit dirty, so I'm going to clean it a bit. I touched the color with the dark area with my hand and I just smudged it a bit. But I'm using my needleball eraser to erase it. So I created here a very light petal. I'm going to leave it like this. I'm not going to create some shading or something. I just want to leave that pure color there. And now I'm going to continue here by adding a darker shading by using the cadmium red color, cadmium orange color. I'm going to create a darker area here to combine it with the brown one, and a bit here. Like this. And now I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow again to create a base layer here. And this is going to be a very dark area of the flower. I'm going to jump in right with my cadmium orange color to make it darker already. Something like this. So my camera stopped and I'm really sorry for that, because my battery was dead. So the first time it stopped because I can't film only 30 minutes, and this time it stopped because the battery was dead. But now I charged it and I can come back to the drawing. So where was I? I'm going to clean this first. I was here. This is going to be a very dark area, and that's why I'm going to jump right in with my cadmium orange color, just to add a bit of a darker shading. And here as well, I'm going to add a very fine line at the end of this petal, just because I didn't like the how it looked like. Looked like it's getting lost into the white of the paper. It looked like it's getting lost into the white of the paper. So now I'm going to add a bit of a shadow here and pick up my dark chrome yellow just to burnish this up a bit and to add a bit more vibrancy and to make that blending look smoother. Because right now you can see the tooth of the paper and it's not very nice. That's why I'm burnishing it now, to make everything look very nice and smooth. And I'm going to pick up my walnut brown color now and to make things even darker, but by applying a very light pressure. I don't want to make it too dark, just want to give it a darker tint. And applying very light pressure. And I noticed in the reference photo that here it's like a triangle and it's darker than the rest, so I'm going to mark it out now. Like this. And I'm going to pick up my dark chrome yellow color again to burnish everything again a bit, especially this shadow I just created here with my walnut brown. I just want to make it look vibrant, more vibrant, because it was very too brown and it looked too muddy. I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow to add some vibrancy to it, something like this. And as I said in my previous videos, if you can see my hand being blurry, it's because I set my camera to focus on the drawing. So as you can see, it doesn't matter where I put my hand, it's going to focus on the drawing, because that's the important thing of the video, the drawing, not my hand. So I think it's a good idea for you guys to have a better look at the drawing instead of seeing my hand always moving. So now I'm going to use my dark light cadmium yellow just to add a bit more color to the whole area. And cadmium orange a bit to darken this area a bit more. And as well the sides. And I was thinking to add a bit of shadow here as well. So I'm going to add a very small and subtle shade in here at the end of the petal. And I researched how those are called, because in my first video when I was drawing the body, I called those antennas, but I just found out that they're called antennas, something like this, antennas. So if you're watching the first part, you're going to hear me keep saying antennas, but normally they are called antennas. A very hard word, but I know now for sure. So next time I'm going to draw a bug or something, I'm going to tell it correctly. I think I said antennas because in Romania they are called antenne, and it was similar to, I thought that in English they are going to be called antennas, but as I said, apparently they are called antennas. So I know for the future videos now. So I created a very light shading there, and I'm going to add a bit more cadmium yellow on the background of this area, so around this dark area. And now I'm going to move to the next area, which is this one. And as I might see from my reference photo, it is kind of a light area, but I'm going to mark it out a bit, so it goes like this, and then here. So this area here is going to be a bit darker. And this one here as well, but mostly the light is going to be the dark, the lightest area is going to be here, so I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow to mark it. I need to be very careful with the antennae around it, because it's very dangerous to smudge it, so that's why I recommend you guys to be very careful not to pick up the black from the antennas and put it in your light areas, because it's going to look very smudgy and muddy, and we don't want that. So I'm going to pick up my cadmium orange color and to add a very hard pressure here. And here a bit. And a bit more light cadmium yellow here. Something like this. And now I'm going to use my walnut brown just to add a bit more contrast and make things look a bit darker. For example, here I'm going to add a bit this area and a bit here around this very bold line. I want to make it a bit smoother. I'm going to add some shading around it using my walnut brown color. I want to make it look more natural, because now it looks too sharp. And I don't like that. I want to make a nicer transition between the shadow and the highlight. Something like this. A bit more. And if you hear me talk louder sometimes, it's because of the neighbors again, when they are using like a very loud machine. I'm talking a bit louder and hoping that I'm going to cover that sound, but I'm going to find out and I'm going to edit it. But at least I'm trying, and hopefully it's going to work. So I create a very smooth transition, and I'm going to add a bit of it more here and here. I'm going to use my black color just to make this antennae a bit longer. It goes all the way here. To use a bit of walnut brown as well in this area here, just to make it darker, because it's very dark in the reference photo. So I need to apply a harder pressure. I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow just to make that a bit more vibrant. and a bit of black, just a bit, to separate those two areas here, and to add a bit of contrast here and here. First I'm going to make this a bit darker, don't want to lose that antennae in the flower. I'm going to add a bit of a shadow here, and as you can see, the tip of my pencil, it's so sharp and long, and I use this for that, the Kum eraser, the masterpiece, and it has two levels. So it has two levels, level 1 and level 2, so first we need to sharpen it here, and after we need to sharpen it in this part to make it look very sharp. And I love that sharpener. I'm going to clean this a bit because I just noticed I smudged it. So I don't know if it's only me, but I really love when my pencils are very sharp, for example like this. It gives me another feeling of the drawing. I don't know how to explain, but feels nicer to draw with a very sharp tip. That's why I sharpen them like this. So I'm going to add a bit of black here in the beginning. A bit here and a bit here. There's no black in the reference photo, but I really want to make the contrast a bit higher. And now let's move in this area here. Which is going to be very light. So I'm going to mark it a bit. I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow to add a base layer. And I'm going to add as well a bit of light cadmium yellow color, just to burnish everything up a bit and make it look more vibrant like always. Now applying a bit of a harder pressure. And I really hope my camera is going to focus. I am really proud of how the butterfly turned out. This is my first realistic butterfly I have ever drawn, and I'm pretty pleased with the result. It's been so much fun to draw the contrast between the black and the orangey color. And it was as well a lot of fun to create all those white areas. And I really enjoyed it, and I hope you're going to enjoy it as well if you're going to draw together with me. So now I'm going to use some dark chrome yellow again, just very light layer. Like this. And I'm going to create a bit of a small shadow here between, in the middle, and in the reference photo, something is happening here. So I'm going to create a bit of a shading as well. And some lines. This one is very dark, so I'm going to use my walnut brown to create it, because it's very dark. And I'm going to pick up my cadmium yellow again. My cadmium orange, sorry. I need to clean my hand a bit because I took some pigment from the black area and I noticed I'm putting it all over the drawing. So I'm going to create a shading here. I'm going to pick up my walnut brown and add a bit here at the base of the shadow to make it a bit darker. And I just noticed a bit more shadow here, so I'm going to use my cadmium orange for that. I'm going to add a small shadow. Hope the flower is not going to take me as much as the parts of the butterfly, because it's much easier to draw and it should take me less time. I know for you guys the most interesting part is the butterfly. I just noticed here it's not very dark, but I want to make it dark like this, just to make this area pop out. I'm going to use a lot of hard pressure to make that area dark as well, a bit here to combine those two areas. And as well my walnut brown to make it a bit darker here on the base. Now I'm going to work on this one. It's a pretty big area, but first I'm going to mark a shadow. I see one here and a very small one here, so I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow for the base layer. Again, applying a very light pressure and holding my pencil as far as possible from the tip. As I said before, I have never drawn a flower before, so I'm just testing it now as well. And I hope it's going to look good in the end. I'm doing my best, but if it doesn't look as good as the butterfly, it's because I don't have experience with flowers. And now I'm going to pick up my light cadmium yellow and apply a harder pressure just to smoothen everything up a bit, and as well to add some vibrancy to the to that petal. And now I'm going to pick up my cadmium orange color and add some shading. For example, I see one shading here, but it's not a very dark shading, so I'm going to be careful with the pressure. I don't want to combine those two. I want to leave some contrast between them. So here's a small shadow casted by this big petal here. So I'm going to try to make sure it looks like a shadow, and as well a very small shadow here, a darker shadow. Like this. And I'm going to add as well a very, very light shadow here. Just barely touching the paper. As well here. Being very careful, taking my time, and I'm working in circular moves just to spread the pigment of the pencil everywhere, and to make sure I don't leave any areas untouched. And if you listen to my video now and it has some music on the background from the beginning of the video, it's because, as I said in a few minutes ago, or half an hour ago, I've decided that I want to add some music on the background, just to cover those noises from the neighbors. So if you're going to hear me at one moment in the video saying that I want to put some music on the background, but the background music is going to be there from the start of the video, that's what the reason is, because I decided that only on the halfway of the video. So you're going to hear me at one moment for sure saying that I'm going to put some music on the background over my voice. And now I'm going to use again my dark light cadmium yellow, to add a bit more vibrancy here and to combine those two colors. I'm going to use my cadmium orange color again, just to add a fast shading here on this petal. And a bit of black to make it darker. Want to create a very nice transition between the dark and the dark red, orange, actually it's an orange color. Like this. And a bit of black here as well. I'm going to use my slice tool to create a very nice highlight here. And here as well. I'm going actually to use now a craft knife, in case you guys don't have a slice tool. A craft knife works as well. I'm going to show you now. So this is a regular craft knife. I'm going to create the highlight here. I want to show you guys that you don't have to spend a lot of money for a slice tool. You can as well use a very cheap craft knife from like your Hobby Lobby, or you can find it in a craft store, or do it yourself store. And they are very cheap and they work very good. And now I'm going to pick up my cadmium orange color again. And to work a bit on this area. Here as well. And now I'm going to work on this area here, which is again a very dark area. I'm going to mark it out, and this part is going to be very dark, and as well here. So I'm going to first use my light cadmium yellow to add a base layer. And now I'm going to use my dark chrome yellow to combine those two colors a bit. Like this. And now again a cadmium orange color to add one more layer. First I want to clean the drawing a bit because I keep smudging it everywhere. I don't want to put a piece of paper over it because I want for you guys to be able to see the whole drawing, and this is a small drawing, so I don't really need a piece of paper over it because I can reach this area from here. But if it was a big drawing, then this part would have been done. So I'm going to use my light cadmium yellow color, and I'm going to leave it untouched. I want to leave it like this, like a very even color and very bright color, because that's the color I see it in the reference photo as well. But I think I need to add a bit of dark cadmium orange, or I'm going to tell you now, a bit of dark chrome yellow to make it look more orangey. This almost there. A bit more pressure. and I think that's enough. And a bit of cadmium orange here. Like this. Another dark area here. I'm going to use my cadmium orange for that part and apply a harder pressure to make it very dark. And now I'm going to use the light cadmium yellow to add some vibrancy to it. And as well some walnut brown to make it a bit darker. For example, a bit darker here. I want to create a transition between the brown and the orange, so I'm going to apply very light pressure and be very careful. A bit more here, and as well I'm going to use a bit of black here at the start of the petal just to create more depth. And that's it. And now let's move to the next area, which is this one here, and it is as well a very light area. I'm going to do the same like I did here, just add those two colors, the light cadmium yellow and as well the dark chrome yellow. Just mix them together. I'm going to try to make this one a bit darker, like this, just to give more contrast to the drawing and more realism. And a bit of cadmium orange, to create a very small shadow here. Something like this, and I'm going to work on this leg here because it goes like this. It gets lost into the flower. So I'm going to leave it like this and add a bit of black here. And now another very dark area. This one here, I'm going to mark it. Even darker than this one. hide this, and I'm going to use the darkroom yellow to burnish it and to make it look more vibrant. By applying a very hard pressure and make sure I cover the whole area. I don't want to be able to see that grain of the paper. I want to make it very nice and smooth. Something like this. And now to use my walnut brown color to add a bit more shadow here. A bit here. I noticed this one is very dark. And this area here as well. And a bit more here. And now I'm going to use my darkroom yellow to make those browns look a bit more vibrant by applying again a very high pressure. Like this. And maybe even a bit of black here. Here as well. Of course, some highlights, one here, one here, here as well. I'm going to use my white pencil now to make those highlights a bit lighter. And more visible as well. Like this. And this area here is going to be as well very light. No shading at all. And I used my light cadmium yellow, and now I'm going to use the dark chrome yellow just to mix them together. I'm going to add a small line with my black pencil here to separate those two areas. This and another very light area is here, this one, to erase this sketch a bit here because it shouldn't be there. Like this. I'm applying a very hard pressure. Followed by darkroom yellow, just here in the beginning, and to combine those two colors a bit, the
quite a smooth transition. So I'm working on this transition between the light and the dark here. Like this, and a bit of light cadmium yellow here and here to connect those two areas. Like this. A small highlight here. And a bit of walnut brown here because it is a very dark area. Followed by dark chrome yellow to make it more vibrant. I'm going to add from my imagination like some lines here to create movement of the petal, so it looks like it's coming from here and goes down. I think it looks much better. I'm going to clean it a bit again because I'm going to clean it a bit again because I smashed it again with my hand. And another section I'm going to work is this one, which is going to be like this. It's going to be again a very dark color. And this one is not in the reference photo, I'm just doing it to make this pop out here. This petal pop out. So I'm just creating an imaginary petal. And as well to give the flower more movement. I'm going to add a bit here as well, a bit of cadmium orange. Make it combine those two areas a bit. And a bit of dark chrome yellow to burnish everything up. And some walnut brown just to add some contrast. So I'm taking my time to create a transition between the brown and the orange, and as well here. Here as well. And I think it was good. one more very light area here. So I'm using my light cadmium yellow. Just leave it like that. And a bit of dark yellow chrome here as well. And of course a bit in the here in the in this area. And here as well, I'm going to add a base layer with my dark chrome yellow color. These areas are not in the reference photo. I'm just creating them from my imagination, just to make the flower have a better flow. I don't want it to look too weird. And a bit of walnut brown as well, just here, to create a bit of movement as well. And again, some walnut brown here. Followed by light cadmium yellow to make it vibrant. And again a very light, very fast and light area here. Here as well. And I think that's it. I just finished my first real-time tutorial. I really hope you are going to enjoy all those parts. There are 4 parts. And as well that are going to draw together with me, and tag me in your Instagram story or post to see your end result. I will be very grateful if you do that, and as well if you draw along with me and listen to what I have to say and to my tips and tricks. I really hope you enjoyed it and you had fun drawing it, and that my explanations were good. If you want to see more videos of this kind as well, tutorials about mostly pet portraits, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to be notified every time I post a new video. I'm posting one time a week for sure, but sometimes even 2 times a week. That's not every week, but I'm doing my best to post 2 times a week as often as possible. And like I said, I'm really looking forward to see your end results. All the parts are going to be found in the description below. And as well, don't forget to join my group on Facebook, Dragos Pepina Line Colored Pencil Tutorials. I'm looking forward to see you there as well. And that's all. Have a nice day, and again, I hope you enjoyed it and that you are going to subscribe to my channel and like this video. And see you in the next one. Bye guys, have a nice day wherever you are.